linear equation here, we know how to handle that. We isolate the variable. We'll start by simplifying both sides. Over here on the left, the 5 and the 9 give us 14, so we have 14 minus 4m. Over here on the right, we have to start with the distributive property, distribute the 5. 5 times 3 is 15. 5 times m, of course, that's just 5m. And we still have that minus 9m out there. We can't simplify the left anymore. But on the right, we can combine the 5m and the 9m. 5m minus 9m gives us minus 4m. Now, to isolate the variable, we get all the variables on one side. So I'm going to add 4m to both sides to move this 4m over. So I'm going to add 4m, add 4m. So over here, of course, the minus 4m and the plus 4m cancel, and we're just left with 15. And over here, the minus 4m and the plus 4m cancel, and we're left with 14. Wait a second! 14 isn't equal to 15, no matter how large you draw the 14 or how small you draw the 15. Those two aren't equal. What's going on here? Forget it. Let's do this. All right, I'm going to start same equation here. I'm going to pick some values of m, stick them in there, and try to figure out what's actually going on. Because when I simplified this equation, I got 14 equals 15, and that's not right. So let's try m equals 0. If I put m equals 0 in both sides of this, what happens? Well, that just goes away and leaves 14 on the left. And on the right, well, that'll be 3. 5 times 3 is 15 minus 0. Well, that's still 15. And we already know that 14 and 15 aren't equal. M equals 0 doesn't work. Let's try m equals 1. We put that in here. That gives us 5 minus 4 is 1, plus 9 is 10. Put 1 in over here. 3 plus 1 is 4, times 5 is 20, minus 9 is 11. They're not equal either. All right, let's try m equals 2. Put that in here. 5 minus 8, negative 3, plus 9 gives us 6. Put 2 in over here. 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 times 5 is 25. Minus 18 gives us 7. 6, not equal to 7. What's going on? All right, m equals 3. We know that 0, 1, and 2 don't work. Let's try 3. Put in 3, 5 minus 12, that's negative 7, plus 9 is 2. I'll put 3 in over here. 3 plus 3 is 6, times 5 is 30. And then I'll subtract 27. And that gives, hey, wait a second. Once again, 2 is not equal to 3, but each time the right side is ending up 1 greater than the left side. That's what this is telling us right here. When we simplified this, we have 14 minus 4m equals 15 minus 4m. No matter what I put in for m here, this side's going to be 1 greater than that side. This is 15 minus 4m. This is 14 minus 4m. This side's always going to be 1 greater than this side. So no matter what I put in for m, these two can never be equal. And that's what it means when I start with a linear equation and I simplify it and I get an equation that can never be true. That tells me that the original equation can never be true. No value of m works here. So this equation has no solutions. Very tricky. All right, well, that one tripped us up, but let's try a different one. Maybe we'll do better with this. Again, we know the drill here. We'll simplify both sides and try to isolate the variable. Over here on the left, we'll combine the minus 3w and the plus 6w, and that'll give us plus 3w. Now, over here on the right, we'll distribute the 3. Minus 3 times 3, that gives us minus 9. Minus 3 times minus w, that gives us a plus 3w. Left side, we can't simplify that anymore. We have 5 plus 3w. And the right side, 14 minus 9, of course, is 5. And we're going to want to subtract the 3w from both sides to get all the w's together. And then happened again. 3w minus 3w, the w's go away. 3w minus 3w, the w's go away. 5 equals 5. Well, at least 5 does equal 5. At least we get an equation that's actually true this time. But what does it mean? We'll try the same thing again. Try sticking in a few different values of w and see what happens. If we put in 0, well, 5 minus 0 plus 0, that's still 5. Then over here, 3 minus 0 is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Subtract the 9 from 14, we get 5. Sure enough, they're both equal, so w equals 0 works. That's the solution. But is it the only one? Let's try another one just in case. If I put in 1, Well, let's say I get 5 minus 3, that's 2, plus 6 is 8. If I put 1 in over here, 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 times the 3 is 6. I subtract 6 from 14, I get 8. W equals 1 works too. Well, I found two solutions, maybe there are more. If I put in 2, well, 5 minus 6 is negative 1, plus 12 is 11. I put 2 in over here, 3 minus 2 is 1, times 3 is 3, subtract 3 from 14, yeah, you guessed it. Looks like everything works. Hey, that's what this is telling us. When we simplify both sides of this equation, we simplify it, we get the same thing on both sides. That tells me no matter what I put in for W, these two are going to be the same. No matter what I put in for W, both sides of the original equation are going to give the same value. So that means every single value of W is a solution to this equation. So all numbers work in this equation. All right, so to recap, we've seen linear equations from way back. They all seem to have one solution. Well, now we've seen two different new kinds of equations. First, if we simplify both sides of the equation, we get down to something that's never true. That tells us the original equation has no solutions at all. If we simplify the equation, we get to an equation that is always true. That tells us that every value of the variable works in the equation. So I've seen linear equations, they can have no solutions, they can have exactly one solution, or they can have infinitely many solutions. But are there any other possibilities? Can a linear equation have just two solutions? Just three solutions? I'll let you figure that out for yourself.